Welcome to this video showing you how to get started with the Roxtec Transit Designer. To create a new project, just click the Create New Project button. Give the project a name and a category. If applicable, choose a certifying authority. Click Next. Now this is your product overview. This is where all your transits in your product will be collected later on. Click the Add Transit. Choose the single solution. Give the transit a name and click Next. Now to create a transit within Transit Designer, you do this in three simple steps. First, you tell the system your cables and pipes, or both. You choose a Roxtec solution, and then you place the Roxtec modules inside. And that's it, you have a transit. Now in the Insert Cables and Pipes step, you start by typing your cable diameter, an optional category, and the number of cables. You can add rows as you go. Now, as an alternative way to have approximate cable lists like this, you can insert a excellest. Then you go into the detail mode. You see that the cable list will turn into somewhat of an Excel grid. You go over to your Excel spreadsheet, take an existing cable schedule, copy it, and paste it using your keyboard shortcut, Control-V. If you're not sure about your keyboard shortcut to paste, click here. Let's go to the next step. Now, Transit Designer will let you explore all the possible solutions for that cable list in different categories. You can explore the Roxtec solutions by clicking on these categories, or you can use the filter mechanism to filter for solutions that will be applicable to you. When you select a solution, the next thing will be to configure it. Choose the installation type and the solution material. If you have EMC requirements, you can select that here, but I will just go for the standard transit. Now your solution entered the canvas. We have already selected a size for you. You can view your used space in the left panel, and this is according to your cable schedule and the frame size. The important thing here is the geometry. You can change the geometry by clicking on the right-hand panel, and you can see at the same time that your used space is being updated. Change the geometry to something that will fit your application. You can change the window size as well. The next step is to place the Roxtec modules. You can either place them by doing an auto place, or you can place them manually by grabbing either one cable or several cables. You can filter for them, for instance, power cables, and make sure you can put all of them in the same opening. You can click on the individual cables and place them as you like. Once you're happy with these cables, you can use Alt to place the rest of them. And that's it, you just created your first transit. Now to generate your documents, just go to the Get Documents dialog. From here you can export bill of material, your drawings, and your 3D files. Even tailor-made installation instructions for this type of installation and this frame. Just click Download. Let's look at the package. First we have the drawing package with a hole cut drawing. This is for the structure. Then the overview drawing stating the modules used or not and the complete bill of material. It also includes the cable pulling drawing with the detailed cable information on what cable that goes where and all the rest of the information. An additional information drawing states all the dimensions of that frame. The 3D step file would be nice to put in your 3D assembly. The Excel bill of material includes all your summarized material, the frame and the packing material, and your cable schedule. Now when you're done, just click close. And congratulations, you just created your first transit within Roxtec Transit Designer. Now there's a lot of tutorials and video guides on how to use the system in the knowledge base, so don't miss out on that. Now one last thing, if you ever get stuck within the system or have any questions regarding how to use the software or how to use the Roxtec products, go to the chat window here. You'll be able to chat with a Roxtec representative and ask any questions you like. Now that's all for the getting started video. Thank you for watching.